Good morning students, Sairam. I am Anuravi Shankar. This session I am going to science. The name of the chapter is Natural Resources, Air, Water and Land. Chapter number 1. Children, are you ready? Shall I start? What we will study? First one is Natural Resources. What is meant by Natural Resources? Air. Proportion of the various gases in the air. Uses of gases in air. And last one is air pollution. These all things we are going to study in this session. Are you ready, children? Shall I start? Yes, children, see here one picture I have given in this slide. You have to observe this picture. What you will see? Yes, here. Children, here one, what is here? Yes, cow is here. And here what is? Yes, some fishes are in water. Next one is here, clouds, birds. Next one is one, aeroplane is here. And one, boat. And next, water is there, trees. These all things are here. Can you see? Yes. You can see that many things in the picture are in water, some on land and some in the sky, that is in the air. These all things on the earth are associated with air, water and land. So children, in that picture you can see many things in the, that means in water, and some things on land, some in the sky, isn't it? So these all things on the earth are associated with air, water and land. So that air, that is earth's atmosphere, water part, that is what? Earth's hydrosphere, and land, that is lithosphere. Different living things occupy these three spheres of the earth. Which three spheres? Yes, atmosphere, water part, that is hydrosphere, land, that is called what? Lithosphere. So different living things occupy these three spheres of the earth, isn't it? So see here, what is meant by biosphere? Now you know that what is meant by, what is atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere, you know. Now what is meant by biosphere? These living things and the parts of the lithosphere, see here children, here atmosphere, that means air, and lithosphere, and that is land. Next one is hydrosphere, that is what? Yes, water. So these living things and the parts of the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere which they occupy are together called the biosphere. Now got it? Biosphere means the living things are occupy where? This lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. So together that is called what? Biosphere. I hope you got it. You got now. Yes. Can I go to next? So the atmosphere is the layer of air. Already I told that air, that is called what? Earth's atmosphere. So the atmosphere is the layer of air that surrounds the earth. The surface of the earth. So atmosphere, that is surround the earth. Next one is surface of the earth comprises water and land. That means water, that is called what? Yes, hydrosphere, and land, that is called what? Lithosphere. See here children, the hydrosphere occupies a much larger part than the lithosphere. See children, the proportion of land and water on the earth. See here, here this blue part, that is what? Water part, and these are what? This is land, that is 29% land, and remaining part occupies by water. So the hydrosphere occupies a much larger part than the lithosphere, isn't it? Because here water occupies 71%, remaining part, that is 29% part, is occupied by land. What is meant by natural resources? Air, water and land are the factors important for sustaining the living world on the earth, and for fulfilling their basic needs. So what is meant by natural resources? Air, water and land are the factors important for sustaining, that means supporting, giving support for sustaining the living world on the earth and for fulfilling that all living organisms are getting their basic needs with the help of this air, water and land. That's why they are called natural resources. Okay, so here which three factors are sustaining the living world? Yes, air, water and land. Okay, so it is called what? Natural resources. Understood now? So which three important three factors are there? Air, water and land. Children, understood? So five layers of atmosphere. First one, this session I am going to teach air. That air part of that is called what? Earth's atmosphere. So Earth's atmosphere is divided into five layers. This name already you had studied in your fifth standard, I think, isn't it? So what are the five layers of atmosphere? First one is what? Yes, troposphere. Next one is stratosphere. Next one is mesosphere, thermosphere, exosphere. Okay, so first layer is what? Troposphere. Next one is stratosphere. See the kilometer here distance. Next one is what? Mesosphere. Fourth one is thermosphere. And last one is exosphere. Okay, so Earth's surface, that atmosphere, first layer is what? Troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. Air. The air in the atmosphere around the earth contains. So that atmosphere contains what? Air. Okay, mixture of gases. So it contains which gases? See here, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, six inert gases. Okay, six inert gases, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, water vapor and dust particles. So our atmosphere, Earth's atmosphere contains mixture of gases. Which gases? What are the name? Tell me. Yes, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, six inert gases, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, water vapor and dust particles. Children, understood? Can I go to next? The amount of the gases. Already you know atmosphere contains what? Yes, mixture of gases. So the amount of the gases in the air is the greatest near the surface and it decreases as we go higher and higher from the surface. So Earth's, see here at that surface, atmosphere contains what? Here Earth's atmosphere has five layers. So where the gas, the amount of gas is more, that we will see now. The troposphere, first layer is what? Troposphere. It contains about 80% of the total mass of gases in the air, while this proportion is about 19% in the stratosphere, next layer. Okay, so first layer contains what? Troposphere. It contains what? 80% of the total mass of gases. Next layer, that is stratosphere, it contains what? 19% remaining. Further in the mesosphere, gases are not found in the exosphere or beyond. Now you have to see here, children, the amount of the gases in the air is the greatest near the surface. Okay, near the earth surface, the amount of gases is greatest, at the same time decreases as we go higher and higher from the surface. Okay, understood? Can I go to next? Yes, this chart shows the proportions of the constituents of air. Air contains the gases, already we saw, isn't it? So the proportions of the constituents of air, see here this chart. Here, yes, first one is the blue part, that is what? Nitrogen. Atmosphere contains 78% of nitrogen. Next one is oxygen. See here, children. Yes, oxygen, how much of percentage here? Yes, 21%. Next one is carbon dioxide is 0.03%. Other constituents of air, that is 0.07%. Next one is argon. Argon is what? 0.9%. So here, which one is more? Yes, nitrogen. The proportion of the various gases in the air, which gas is more here? Yes, nitrogen. Next one is oxygen. Next one is oxygen. Shall I go to next? Some uses of gases in air. So already I have told here, atmosphere contains what? Air, mixture of air, and here some uses of gases in air. So what are the uses of gases in our atmosphere? First one is what I told, yes, the atmosphere contains 78% of what? Nitrogen. So nitrogen, what is uses of nitrogen? Nitrogen helps living things to build the necessary protein. What are the uses of nitrogen? First one is helps living things to build the necessary protein. Protein is one of the important food constituent for us, isn't it? So this nitrogen helps living things to build the necessary protein. Production of ammonia. This ammonia is one of the chemical. So the production of ammonia, the nitrogen is used to produce ammonia, and in airtight packaging of foodstuff. Nowadays we are getting many food things in airtight box. So that nitrogen is used in airtight packaging of foodstuff. Next one is oxygen. You know that oxygen is present in our atmosphere. What is the uses of oxygen? Yes, necessary for respiration in living things. The respiration process is there in our body, isn't it? So we are intaking and exhaling. We are intaking what? Yes, oxygen. We are while breathing, which gas will go to inside of your body? Yes, oxygen. That oxygen from where you will get? Yes, from our atmosphere. So oxygen, what is uses of oxygen? Oxygen, it is used for respiration in living things. Shall I go to next? Dioxide. Plants use it for producing food. In your 5th standard, you had studied about photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means what, children? Yes, the plants are producing their food with the help of chlorophyll, sunlight, and carbon dioxide. So what is the uses of carbon dioxide? Yes, plants use it for producing food. So for photosynthesis process, carbon dioxide is necessary. So that is the one of the main uses of carbon dioxide. Next one is what? Used in fire extinguishers. So that fire extinguishers you might have seen in your school, malls, theater, isn't it? So that carbon dioxide is used to produce fire extinguishers. Okay, next one is argon. Already I told here that atmosphere contains inert gas. So here argon, helium, these are the inert gas. Okay, so argon used in electric bulbs. You might have seen the electric bulbs. So that argon is used in electric bulbs. Helium used for obtaining low temperature. What is the uses of helium? Yes, used for obtaining low temperature. Next one is neon. Neon also one of the inert gas. Okay, neon used in decorative lights and for street lighting. So in front of shop you might have seen many decorative lights in any festival time, isn't it? So that neon is used in decorative lights and for street lighting. Next one is krypton. Krypton used in fluorescent tube. Nowadays you can get many type of fluorescent tube from market. So the krypton is used in fluorescent tubes. Next one is xenon. Xenon, where it is used in flash photography. So during photography from the camera the light is coming, isn't it? So that is what flash. We are saying that is flash. So that xenon is used in flash photography. So children, understood what are the uses of gas in our atmosphere? Shall I go to next? Children, observe this picture. Yes, what you will see here? Yes, here what is this? From factory, smoke is releasing. And here also smoke is coming, isn't it? And here, yes, fire, forest fire. So here also this black color substance is what? Yes, smoke. Yes, these pictures show scale emission of smoke through different agencies, isn't it? So this smoke directly mixes with the atmosphere, disturbing the balance between the constituents of air. So the smoke is coming from the factory, and if any forest fire, so the smoke is coming. That smoke will mix to, yes, that smoke will mix with our atmosphere. So that is disturbing the balance between the constituents of air. This is called what? Air pollution. This is called what? Air pollution. So that air, already atmosphere contains some particular proportion of gases. So if this smoke will mix with our atmosphere, it will disturbing what? It will disturb our, that balance between the constituents of air. And this is called what? Air pollution. This is called what? Air pollution. So is it useful or what? Yes, it is very harmful for us. So harmful gases are given out through combustion of fuels in vehicles and in big industries. As a result, air pollution is increasing day by day. So see here children, harmful gases are given out through combustion of fuels. In many factories the smoke is coming, at the same time vehicles. Vehicles also, from the vehicles also the smoke is coming, isn't it? So that is what will be the result? Yes, that result, air pollution is increasing day by day. That air pollution is very harmful for living organisms. Harmful substances released in air through combustion of fuels. So harmful substances are released in air through combustion of fuels. What are the name? Yes, see here, nitrogen dioxide, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and soot. See here children, once again I'll read here. Which harmful substances released in air through combustion of fuels? See here, nitrogen dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and soot. Soot is the black color powder like substance. It is mixed with our atmosphere. Okay. So these harmful substances released in air through combustion of fuels. So children, today what we studied about? Yes, this session what we studied? Yes, natural resources. What is meant by natural resources? And what are the three important factors? Yes, air, land and water. Next one is, this session I've taught about air. That means Earth's atmosphere. It contains different kind of gases. Air, various gases of air. Which gas is more? Yes, nitrogen. Next one is oxygen and some inert gas, isn't it? And their uses. What are the uses of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, inert gases? That also we saw today. Next one is air pollution. Air pollution means that is disturbing of constituents of air. How it is getting disturbance? Yes, mixture of unwanted things to our atmosphere. Okay, so that smoke, how the smoke is coming? Yes, from big factory and forest fire, from vehicles. So that air pollution is increasing day by day. So it is very, yes, it is very harmful for us, isn't it? So children, I hope you understood today's session. Yes, next session we will study about land. Okay, children, I hope you understood. Yes. Thank you, children. Sairam.